गुड मॉर्निंग डियर चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू टुडेज क्लास। एज यू ऑलरेडी नो दैट योर प्री मिड टर्म एग्जाम इज ऑलरेडी ओवर एंड द मंथ ऑफ ऑगस्ट इज ऑल्सो कम्प्लीटेड। यू हैव स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम सेप्टेम्बर। नाउ दिस इज योर वर्क बुक। एज यू हैव ऑलरेडी सीन दिस इन योर ब्रॉडकास्ट, दिस इज थिंकर एक्टिव मैथमेटिक्स वर्क बुक विच इज अलॉन्ग विथ योर पैकेज ऑफ बुक्स विच यू हैव माइट हैव परचेज्ड। It is the Holy Faith Publishers. Already you have seen this photo means of this front page means the cover page I have given in the broadcast group. Now it is the workbook. It is not some people might be thinking what is the use of this and that. It is very very important. It is compulsory to purchase. Here you can see when you open all the chapters, all the exercises related to the chapter which you are studying here in this textbook. All those questions, means some extra questions are also here, means it is given for practice. So the name is given workbook. And it is very very necessary and compulsory to solve. It will give you the practice also. And if when the classes will start, I will be checking also that. Now, when you are going to start this workbook, you have to start this solving by your own from page number 1 to 12. It is exercise 1.3, I think. 1.3 exercise, 1 to 10 number. Up to unit 2 it is. Unit 2 given in page number 12. Unit 2. Question number 12B. Unit 2, question number 12B. Up to here you have to solve, complete and keep. You are getting 1 week time for this. Then further the next exercise of this chapter 1 I will be giving. But up to that, up to that time you have to complete this up to page number 12. And children, please find time, solve this. It will give you the practice also, and then only you will be coming to understand the chapter. And some people might be thinking that even if we don't study, even if we don't complete the notes, or what is the use of this workbook? No, it is not like that. This class 6 is the basic of all the other classes what you are studying in the further classes. Even if you take maths subject or not taking, even if you are taking commerce subject or giving any of the competitive exams also, this class 6 basics what you are studying here, like integers, fractions, whole numbers, decimals, conversions and whatever some laws are also there, some formulas are here in the further chapters, and the basic geometry also. This class 6 is the basic for all that. And this workbook is going to give you more and more practice. So my dear children, please find time and solve these questions. It will give you proper practice. And along with that, you have to also keep your notebook complete, what you are getting through your PDF. Now, this I have told you about the workbook. And notebook you have to complete according to the chapter which is going on in these videos. And video state I have given in the broadcast along with this cover page. The videos for maths class is Tuesday, Wednesday and Friday. These are the 3 days when you are getting maths videos. And whatever PDF also you are getting, only on these 3 days you are getting. So PDF of whichever chapters are necessary, for example like chapter 4, 5 the introduction part I have given, chapter 5 exercises I have given, chapter 6 full exercises I have given. So dear children, complete that notes. Might have left out that for doing the practice of pre-midterm exam. So again continue with that, complete up to chapter 6. Now here we are going to start chapter 7, that is fractions. But here only I am explaining. Just you listen, try to understand. Don't try to copy down it now. Only you try to understand. For writing in the copy, what you have to write in the copy, the introduction part or whatever exercises, that you will get in the PDF only. So here, please try to understand what what is this fraction and what are the different types of fraction and how we will understand whether you can write any number as fraction or not. Fraction. Fraction is actually written in the form P by Q. Now what is this P and Q? This P and Q, they can be any of the whole number for P you can say. Whole number for P. Whole number means 0, 1, 2 and so on. It can be 0 also. And Q. Q only you have to take only the natural numbers. Means 0 you cannot take here. It will start from 1, 2 and so on. Why is it so? Because any number divided by 0 is not defined. This question you have got in your pre-midterm exam question also. Any number divided by 0, the answer is not defined. Means this cannot be the fraction. So for writing the definition, Q cannot be 0. So here we are writing P will be any of the whole number. Means it can be 0, it can be any other number also. And Q can only be the natural number. Means 0 cannot be the Q, means denominator. It is P means it is numerator and Q means it is denominator. Numerator, denominator, you have already studied in previous classes, P and Q. Again here you are repeating and this is a basic for the further classes. P and Q, P is the numerator and Q is the denominator. Where P can be only the whole number starting from 0, all the whole numbers you can take. Q only the natural number, 0 cannot come there because any number divided by 0 is not defined. Now, here you, before this chapter you have studied integers. Integer means negative number are also there. Here only the whole number and natural number you have seen. Means any of the negative number will not come here. Means you cannot take any of the integers. Any of the negative numbers will not come here for the fraction. Now what is actual this fraction? Suppose if I am taking this circle, dividing it into 4 parts, 4 equal parts and shading any of the one part. And if I will ask what is the fraction of this shaded part? So how many parts shaded? 1 part shaded. Out of total how many parts? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 parts are there. So 1 out of total 4 is shaded. So this is the fraction. Like suppose marks, how you are getting the marks in any of the exam. Suppose you got 15 out of 20. So like this you are getting, this is the marks scored, this is the total marks. This total you are writing in the denominator and how much you have scored, that you are writing in the numerator. Next, some of the fractions you can cancel and bring it to the lowest form and some fractions are not possible to cancel. And that will only be the lowest form. Like suppose this 1 and 4 cannot be cancelled because 4 is only the greatest or by the table of 1 only it can be cancelled. Means only 1 by 4 will be there. This 15 and 20 is coming in any of the tables common, that is table of 5. So 5, 3 is 15, 5, 4 is 20. Again can you cancel it? No, it cannot be cancelled. So 3 by 4. This is called as the simplest form or the lowest form. This is the simplest form of this fraction. Any other example if I take? What will be the fraction of this? This is 3 out of total 4. This is 3 by 4 like that only. So this is the fraction how we are writing. Now comes the types of the fraction. Earlier only I told it cannot be the negative. Because only whole numbers and natural numbers we are using for P and Q, that is numerator and denominator. Now coming the types of the fractions. What are the types of fractions? Here just we have seen what 1 by 4 or 15 out of 20 or 3 by 4. These numbers just now we have seen. You have seen here that this numerator by denominator, numerator is only the smaller than the denominator. Numerator is smaller than denominator. numerator is smaller than denominator, numerator is smaller than denominator. Means this kind of fraction is called as proper fraction. This is only the proper fraction. Proper fraction means easily you can divide. Means easily you can divide this fraction. This is called as proper fraction, where the numerator is less than the denominator. This is called as the proper fraction. This is the first type of fraction. Second is improper fraction. Improper fraction, by the name itself it is clear that it will be the opposite of the proper fraction. Opposite of proper is improper. So definitely opposite. Numerator is smaller, denominator is greater. So here it will come opposite. Numerator will be greater than the denominator. Now how it will be? Like suppose 5 divided by 3. Numerator is greater than the denominator. Or 8 by 5. Or 17 by 2. Something like that. Where the numerator is coming greater than the denominator. Such kind of fractions can also be converted into the mixed fraction. How it will be? When you divide the numerator divided by the denominator, the smaller number. By the table of 3, 3, 1 times 3, subtract this 2. It is written as 1, which is the answer quotient, divided by 2 divided by 3. Now this is the proper fraction and this is the whole number. Or you can say the natural number also. Natural number and remainder divided by the divisor. This how you can convert 5 once a 5, remainder 3 divided by 5. 2, 8 is a 16, remainder 1 by 2. 8 is a 16, 1 17, 3 is a 3, 4, 5 by 3, 5 is a 5, 6, 7, 8 by 5. So these are the mixed fractions. This is called as the mixed fraction. It is the third type of fraction. How we are converting? By dividing by numerator divided by the denominator. And dividing like this, answer we will write at the middle part, center part, and then the numerator, the remainder will come in the numerator and this divisor will come in the denominator. This is called as the mixed fraction. So these are the three main types of fractions. Now the next part we will see how we are denoting this proper fraction in the number line. Number line you have studied in the previous chapter, integers. So now we will come to the first type of fraction, that is proper fraction, which we have just now seen, that numerator is smaller than the denominator. For example, 3 by 4. Now we will see how to denote this proper fraction on the number line. Now for this we should know how to mark, means how many divisions or how many parts we have to take in between and between which numbers. How you will come to understand between which two numbers? Definitely everyone know, because just now in the previous chapter we have seen 0, 1, 2, like that marking we are taking. Now this 3 by 4, between which two numbers it will come, how we will come to understand that. For example, this 3 by 4 I have taken. Now 0 by 4 is 0. So for that we have taken 0. Now 3 by 4 will come here somewhere. Now 4 by 4 is 1. 4 and 4 when you will cancel it is coming 1. So 0 by 4 and 4 by 4. It is 0 and 1. So between that somewhere it will come 1 by 4, 2 by 4 and 3 by 4. Between that all these 3 numbers will come. 0 by 4 is 0. 0 by 4 means 0 only and 4 by 4 is 1. So between that 0 and 4, between 0 and 4. Which numbers are coming? 1, 2 and 3. So along with this same denominator 4 and 4 you take. That is 1 by 4, 2 by 4 and 3 by 4. So these three fractions 1 by 4, 2 by 4 and 3 by 4 will lie between 0 and 1. So we have to take up to 1 and between that 4 markings we have to take. This is for example, suppose it is 0 by 4. Now here up 4 division we have to take. This is suppose 1, it is 1 by 4 and it is 2 by 4 and it is 3 by 4 and it is 4 by 4 which is equal to 1. So between 0 and 1 these three numbers are lying and our question is this one. This is your answer. Like this we have to mark. Again repeating. For example 3 by 4 is given. So we have to see between which two numbers this 3 by 4 will lie. So how we will come to understand this? First you take the denominator. Denominator first of course we are starting with 0. So from 0 we are starting. How you will get 0? 0 by 4 is 0. Then next number is 1. After 0 next number is 1. How you will get 1? 4 divided by 4 is equals to 1. So between 0 and 4 which numbers are coming? 1, 2 and 3. Along with the same denominator you take by 4 and by 4. That is 1 by 4, 2 by 4 and 3 by 4. So these three numbers we have to take equal divisions you have to take. It is 0 by 4 and it is 4 by 4. This is 0 and this is 1. So between that three numbers you have to take three fractions. 1 by 4, 2 by 4 and 3 by 4. Your question is 3 by 4. So for that you will encircle. Means this way you are marking for plotting any of the fraction on the number line. So this I have completed this plotting any of the fraction, proper fraction on the number line. Next we will see the improper fraction, that is denominator is greater than the numerator in the next class. By the time you will complete your workbook which I have given the work and the introduction part you will get through PDF, but not now. After completing the first exercise only I will be giving that. Till then thank you for today's class. So types we are seeing proper fraction, then next type is improper fraction where just I have told you that numerator is greater than the denominator. For example we are taking here 3 by 2 or 5 by 4 or 17 by 5, something like that. So here all you can see the numerators are greater than the denominators. So these all are the examples of improper fraction. So now improper fraction require to convert into the mixed fraction. Proper fraction does not require that. And proper fraction cannot be converted to the mixed fraction also. Only improper fractions can be converted to the mixed fraction, which is the third type of fraction, that is the mixed fraction. Now what is this mixed fraction? How we are converting? For example, taking this same only. So mixed fraction, we are dividing the numerator divided by the denominator. Numerator divided by the denominator. So 2, 1 times 2, remainder 1. So first we are writing the quotient. This is the quotient, then the remainder. Remainder, I have written in the different manner this 1 and 1 just to make the difference, to make you understand. This is the one written in this different way and this is the one written in the simple way. So this is the one of quotient and this is the one of remainder and divided by the divisor. So this way it is converted to the mixed fraction. So this one is the whole number and this becomes the proper fraction. Proper fraction just we have seen numerator is smaller than the denominator. So numerator is smaller and denominator is greater. So this mixed fraction means one whole number will come there and the proper fraction will come there. That is combination of the whole number and the proper fraction is the mixed fraction. So improper fraction can be converted to the mixed fraction. Secondly, taking the next example, 5 divided by 4. 4, 1 times 4, remainder 1. So again in the same manner, 1 of the quotient and remainder then divided by 4. Whole number divided by 1 means combination of 1 proper fraction. Taking the third example, 17 divided by 5, 5, 3 is 15, remainder 2. So quotient 3, then remainder and divisor. This is the combination of whole number and the proper fraction. So these are the three types of fractions. First, the proper fraction, where the numerator is smaller than the denominator. Numerator is smaller than the denominator. Second is the improper fraction, where the numerator is greater than the denominator. Examples just I have told you. Then mixed fractions. Only the improper fractions can be converted to the mixed fraction. And what is this mixed fraction? It is the combination of the whole number and one proper fraction. That combination of that is called as the mixed fraction. So these are the three main types of fractions. The next type of fraction is equivalent fraction. That is, equivalent means by the term only here you are coming to understand that equi means equal. Means equal in what manner? How they becomes the equal? For example, 1 by 2, 2 by 4 or 3 by 6 or something like that, 36 by 72, something like that if you are having. So these examples are equivalent fraction. How you come to understand that they are equivalent? For that you will have to understand how to convert these fraction to the simplest form. Simplest form means by cancelling, by cutting, you will come to simplest form. Simplest form means the numerator and denominator will have only one as the common factor. Means they will not come in any other numbers table commonly. Means this 1 by 2. 1 by 2. Only they will come commonly in the table of 1. No other numbers table it will come. So this is the simplest form. 2 and 4. If they both are coming in the table of 2, so we are cancelling. 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. So the lowest form is 1 by 2. Again, if you cannot cancel it, so this is 1 by 2, the simplest form. 3 and 6, they both are coming in the table of 3. So 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. So again, the simplest form is 1 by 2. So like that, again going 36 ones are 36 twos are. So again, you are getting 1 by 2. So these numbers all are having the simplest form or the lowest form as 1 by 2. So everywhere you can see 1 by 2, 1 by 2. So they are coming equal. So these type of fractions are coming under the equivalent fraction. Shall I repeat it again? The numbers or the fractions, when you cancel the numerator denominator, means bring it to the lowest form or bring it to the simplest form. If you are getting the same number, so those numbers or the group of the same fractions, those fractions are coming under the category of equivalent fraction. This is the fourth category, or you can say the fourth type of fractions. Actually the types are only three: proper, improper and mixed. They are the separate just to categorize them, whether they are equal or not equal. That is coming the equivalent fraction. So for that we have seen how to convert in the simplest form. This you have understood here. Here I am just writing the topics which I have taught you here. Proper I have taught, improper, mixed and equivalent fractions I have told. For that you require the simplest form, that I have told. Now next type is the like fractions. Like fraction. This is one type of fraction. What is this like fraction? It's any of the fraction where you are having. Any means not only the one fraction you have to take. Here the group of fractions you have to take. Group of fractions means maybe two fractions or group of three, four, something like fractions you are taking. Like for example, 3 by 7 or 4 by 7, then 7 by 7, something like that. where the denominators are equal or denominators are same, those group of fractions are called as like fraction. Here you are taking only one fraction. Here you are taking only one fraction. Here you are taking only one fraction. Here you are taking the group. Here you are taking the group of fractions for telling the equivalent. For like fractions also you are taking the group of fractions. Means group of fraction where all the denominators are same. Such kind of group of the fractions are called as the like fractions. Then opposite of like will be unlike. So next topic is unlike fractions, means opposite of that. Here also you have to take the group of fractions. Opposite of like, unlike. Here the denominators were same, so here denominators will be different. Whether the numerator is same or do not same, whatever it may be. Like suppose 7 by 5, 7 by 9 or 7 by 20, something like that. Denominators are different. Whether the numerators are same or whether different also. Suppose if I take 8 by 21, 9 by 30, then also. Denominators are different, na? So they all, means this group, all the fractions are unlike fractions. Understood? They can be the comparison of two. Here also comparison of two can be done. Here also comparison of two can be done. And many more can also be taken. Means group also can be taken or comparison of two can also be done. Means at least two are required here for equivalent, for like and unlike. And only one is required for proper, improper and mixed fraction. So in short, again repeating, proper means numerator is smaller than the denominator. Improper means numerator will be greater than the denominator. Mixed fraction means improper you are converting to mixed fraction. Mixed fraction, what is that? The combination of the whole number and the proper fraction. How you are getting? By dividing the numerator divided by the denominator. Equivalent fraction can be done for the comparison of two fractions or for group of fractions also. And how you will understand that? By converting that into the simplest form. Simplest form means by cancelling by the same numbers table. If you are getting the same number for same fraction for both, then you can say yes, they are equivalent. And if you are not getting same, then they are not equivalent. Like fraction where the denominators are same, then you will say yes, the fractions are the like fractions. If the denominators are different, then they are unlike fractions. So these are all the types of fractions. So up to here you have understood what are the different types of fraction and what is only one fraction required, where the comparison can be done. So all this about the topics. Now, what to write in the copy, that I'll be giving you through PDF. Now, you don't have to write anything in your copy. This is just for explanation. Now, this week, you will only complete your workbook. I told you in the beginning of this video that up to page number 12, you have to complete that. This is the workbook I have just shown in the beginning also, and through broadcast also, you have seen that. This is the Thinker Activity Mathematics workbook. Holy Faith Publishers. So this workbook up to page number 12 you will complete only in this week. And at the last of this week I will be giving you the PDF of this chapter. Only one exercise I will be giving. Not giving you too much work of this chapter. By the time you will complete this workbook. So this much we have completed for today. Thank you for today's class.